The Days 360 function is useful in financial transactions where a year is assumed to have only 360 days. To use it, activate the function wizard. In the date and time category, you'll see there's something called Days 360. I'll say OK. You'll see it ask where's the start date. So I'm going to say here, 1st of Jan 2009. End date, 1st of Jan 2010. Method. We can omit it, but basically if you put in a false, you assume it's US-based NASD, or else you can put European methodology by putting true. When we say OK, you'll see it gives us 360 days. So where the actual days are 365 from here to here, Days 360 will give you 360. Let's just copy these down, and you'll see here, between the 5th of July and the 15th of June, actual days are 20 and the days 360 will give you 20. But if you go from the 1st of Jan 09 to the 1st of June 09, actual days 151, but this will give us 150 days, which is quite useful because we can then say this is assuming 30 days a month. So we can actually say that number divided by 30 should give us the number of months between these two dates.